The action of a relativistic point particle of mass m traveling through a d-dimensional Minkowski spacetime can be written like this. When going from the Lagrangian formulation to the Hamiltonian formulation, one can show that the canonical Hamiltonian is identically zero, which leads to so-called primary constraints that are solely responsible for the time evolution of the system. In this video, we want to introduce a different Lagrangian, one that does not lead to primary constraints. And here it is. You'll notice that we not only have x, but also an additional variable called e. E is an auxiliary variable that does not have a proper equation of motion and thus will not introduce any new dynamics into the system. This Lagrangian has two advantages over the previous one. First, it does not contain a square root, which leads to simpler equations of motion. Second, we can easily investigate a massless particle, whereas for the previous Lagrangian, everything would be zero for m equals zero. These advantages are nice, but we also have to show that these two Lagrangians really are equivalent. To do this, we calculate the equations of motion. We get them by demanding that a small variation in a degree of freedom does not change the action, that by using this equation of motion, we are on an extremal point. The equation of motion for E leads to x dot squared plus e squared m squared equals zero. Since there is no derivative acting on E, this is called an algebraic equation in E, and we can very easily solve this. This is what I mentioned earlier, that E does not have a proper equation of motion. The equation of motion for x is a bit trickier to derive, but it's also not immensely difficult. You see that here, a derivative acts on x, therefore this is a good equation of motion. If we take our solution from the first equation of motion and plug it into the action, we get the previous action again. This shows that, classically, the two actions are equivalent. Note, however, that classical equivalence does not automatically imply quantum equivalence. To show quantum equivalence, we would have to check whether both actions yield the same path integral. Finally, let's talk about the constraints. From the previous Lagrangian, we got the primary constraint, which was only the result of the conjugated momenta, not involving the equations of motion. This time, the Hessian matrix is given by the inverse of E times the Minkowski metric. Since the metric is diagonal, we can read off the eigenvalues, none of which are zero. This means no primary constraint. Since we still describe the same system, a relativistic point particle, the constraint p squared plus m squared equals zero must also be present for the new Lagrangian. The short explanation is that, yes, it is present, but it does not just follow from the definition of the conjugated momenta. Instead, we would also have to include the equations of motion. But that's pretty much it for this video. Thanks for watching.